Mr. President, as you know, the world over the past month or so has seen pictures being beamed on television screens across the world of young people who were not at school throwing stones at the police, police firing tear gas, there were barricades. What was going through your mind at that time?
You know that through our history, Burundi passed through many difficulties, especially civil war, conflicts, and many killings. You can imagine if since we have independence in 1962, there was bloodshed, there was also dictatorship to 2005. It means that Burundi passed through those difficulties, and many of Burundians went in exile, and many of them have been killed. That's why even today we have set up the Truth and the Reconciliation Commission in order to see how we can reconcile Burundians people and to build our future, a bright future. So when you what you have seen a few weeks ago, it's not like what you have seen in the past, because in the past there were many killings, many people have been killed, many people went in exile. But today, even if there are small points here in Bujumbura, it was around 10% of the Bujumbura city where there are some small demonstrations. But today, those demonstrations are like finished. It means that we have succeeded to manage them, and there is no many problems about this we have seen through the international media. But what is very important is that Burundi is a peaceful country. We have security. We are helping other countries, Somalia, Central Africa, Ivory Coast. In the near future, we plan also to send one battalion in South Sudan. It means that we have peace and security, and we have succeeded to implement the all ceasefire agreements and the Arusha Peace Accord. So today, we are reaping together, Burundians, with our partners, the dividends of peace.
From where you sit, though, what was responsible for what we saw, the violence that we saw?
Normally, there is no responsibility from our side because, you know, every political party has a right to organize itself for the elections. Yeah, opposition, but also there's the political parties which are on power. So when we are starting campaigning, there's sometimes people who want to see how we can access to the power with violence, or if they have not prepared a very serious elections, they can use also other ways to see how they can disturb the electoral process. What you have seen was only how to disturb the electoral process. But what is very important is also that the international community and all Burundians are together as one to organize successful elections. So today, we are very happy to see that even the international community, the region, have also participated to see how we can support Burundi to organize successful elections.
Well, those who were protesting said they were protesting against your decision to stand for another term.
It's not a matter of my decision. It's come from the political party. You know that according to the law establishing the political parties in Burundi, there is also, it's not only in Burundi, it's also in many countries, even in South Africa, in Tanzania, Uganda. When we are preparing elections, especially for the candidates for the presidential elections, you must respect the outcome of the Congress. That's why, from myself, I was not an independent candidate. I was also given by the political party the seat lifted. It means that it was organized a Congress, a national Congress, for choosing the candidate. And so this Congress have presented me as a presidential candidate for the upcoming elections.
And from where you sit, you've done nothing wrong, you have not broken any law, it's all in terms of the constitution of Burundi.
Even our political party, when they presented my candidate, they say if the candidate is in conformity with the constitution. That's why after my proposals to become the candidate for the presidential elections, the Senate went to ask to the Constitutional Court if the decision is in conformity with the Constitution, and after the Constitutional Court accepted that my candidate is in conformity with the Constitution.
All right, well, there you go. That interview with Pierre Nkurunziza and talking about the situation in Burundi, the president there, that was our Vuyo Mvoko.